Anger, Part 24. Shirish Bhai.
Deepak Bhai, in the beginning of the book, Dada says, we don't want to get angry, but we end up getting angry. Later, Dada says, why don't you get angry with the police officer? So, is there some kind of control? How can we incorporate these two sentences?
The main thing is, it ends up happening even in front of the police officer. Meaning, we end up getting angry even though we're not supposed to. But it happens.
One does not mean to, yet it ends up happening.
Yes, it happens like that. There, we end up getting angry, and here we don't want to do it. The reason behind this is that we have opinions that he's a police officer, he'll do this and he'll do that. Whereas at home, the wife is like a tied-up cow. Even if we belittle her, where is she going to go? There we end up dominating her as a husband. Mainly, there's an opinion behind it. Any work done by the body, more than the words or bodily actions, it's the pain we cause each other through the ego. There are opinions behind it. The children needed to be scolded. If we don't scold them, then they won't improve at all. Whereas for the police officer, we have the opinion, we should not scold him. Otherwise, he'll beat us or give us a ticket. Therefore, we have two kinds of opinions. There's a belief that has been formed behind it that this should be done and this should not be done at all. Now we're correcting it. No matter what kind of situation arises, I want to get my work done through understanding. I don't want to get my work done by quarreling. We are keeping the faith in our belief. When we keep the faith in that knowledge, then gradually it'll come in our conduct. Anger is like a weapon. We get angry for the purpose of getting things done the way we will and want. We get angry to make others do according to our wish. Now, in the state of the ignorance of the self, one has the understanding, I end up getting angry everywhere. It's my weakness. I am the one that ends up getting angry. It's not like that. If your understanding changes, then you will definitely be able to control it. In reality, the control comes through understanding. If one is able to understand perfectly, if someone gets upset while eating, this soup is sour. Now, if the same understanding changes, then he'll stop quarreling with his wife.
In the state of the ignorance of the self.
Whether in the state of the knowledge of the self or in the state of the ignorance of the self, as long as he has a lack of understanding, anger, pride, deceit, greed will arise. When the lack of understanding dissolves, then anger, pride, deceit, greed. Say if some people are talking in the next room, Shirish is like this, he's like that, then you feel angry. And when you hear the last sentence, oh, they're talking about someone from Manchester, it's not me. Then the anger will cool down, won't it?
Yes.
It's like that. When the lack of understanding dissolves, then the anger, pride, deceit, greed fall off.
You just said that we end up getting angry due to a lack of understanding. And secondly, we end up getting angry due to opinions. Are both of them the same?
Opinions are certainly behind it. If we get into the details of the reasons behind the lack of understanding, then there's the negative belief. Beyond that, he has become prejudiced. He wants to do the way he wills and wants. Mainly it's the ego. There's the intellect behind it. So the ego and intellect get together and the turmoil begins. Do you understand?
Yes.
So Dada is giving the understanding to those who have not taken Gnan. You surely have the ability not to get angry at the police officer. If a stone falls from a mountain, then will you quarrel? Whereas if a boy throws a pebble at you, then how angry do you get? You scold a child. You catch a hold of his parents and tell them, your child is like this. You even scold a teacher. Is he learning these things in school? Hey, if children are playing, then this can happen. However, we accuse the living person as being the doer. Because we see the other person as being at fault, that is why we become angry. Whereas, if the stone falls from the mountain, say if a monkey jumps from the tree and a branch falls on us, then we'll just look at him. On the contrary, the monkey will frown at us. We won't be able to say anything to the monkey. If we say, you're like this, you're like that, then he'll make faces at us. So we understand that if we say anything, then he'll attack us. Therefore, it's better to run away from here. Now, will anyone find faults of the monkey? He's living as well. Even then, We realize that it happened due to circumstances. Whereas here, one says, he's doing it intentionally. He's harassing me intentionally. Nobody harasses us intentionally. Nobody can do anything intentionally in this world at all. It is indeed one's own karma that gets finished through apparent doers. It is exact. These talks are even in the Jain scriptures. One binds karma in this way and they get exhausted through apparent doers. What is the fault of the apparent doers? We have bound the causes and we have to suffer the effects. What is the fault of the apparent doer? As the understanding keeps changing, gradually the anger goes away. Julie Mistry.
Why do I end up getting angry at my mother-in-law and father-in-law?
You end up doing that with your mother-in-law and father-in-law.
Yes.
You don't have a problem with your husband, do you?
No.
That's all okay.
He also gets angry.
Your husband also gets angry?
Yes, a lot.
Otherwise, they have good relations with you, right?
Yes, they are good. But it happens sometimes.
Oh, sometimes. Who all have come here? Who have come here out of the three? Mother-in-law, father-in-law, and husband?
Nobody.
You're the only one who's come?
Yes.
No, then there's no problem. Then we can talk freely. Otherwise, we wouldn't be able to talk in their presence. Do they all come to satsang?
No, they don't.
Are they interested in coming?
No.
Did they allow you to come here?
Yes, they allow me to come here.
In that way, they're good, aren't they?
Yes, they are good.
We should look at the positives. We should find one positive out of the 10 negatives. They're good at heart. They're allowing me to come here. They're very nice people. They paid money for this, didn't they? Are you doing pratikraman?
I tried to do it.
Did you learn how to do pratikraman? Did you understand a little?
Yes, a little.
You've taken gyan, haven't you?
Yes.
Have you understand that I am pure soul and file one is separate?
Yes, I have understood.
Then you should do pratikraman, okay? Suppose if the other person gets angry at you, maybe your husband or mother-in-law or father-in-law, if they find a fault in you, then you get upset and think, they're like this and like that. As many negatives as you see, do that many pratikramans. Okay. Then your negative feelings will lessen and thereafter, reactions from them will lessen as well.
Yes.
Now, if you were to throw a football, then the other person would throw it back at you. If you throw it back, then again, then he'll throw it back to you. The game will continue, won't it?
Yes.
If the other person throws the football and you don't throw it back, if he throws a second time and you don't throw it back, then the game will gradually stop, won't it?
Yes.
Similarly, it'll come from his side, but you should remain separate, meaning, Julie, it's your karmic account. It's not his fault. You should do pratikraman. From the day you got married until now, for all of the negative thoughts that have come in your mind, for all of the mistakes you have seen in him, you should ask for forgiveness for all of those. Gradually, as your mind becomes clear, the reactions from his side will decrease.
If I'm not able to remember, then what should I do about that?
What do you not remember? You do remember. They do this. My mother-in-law does this. My father-in-law does this. My husband.
I forget things very quickly.
Do you forget to do the work? Or do you forget the pain that you caused others?
Both.
You forget both. Then it's good. Just enjoy. They'll all complain. You forgot the work? We told you to cook a simple dish of rice and lentils, but you made bread instead. You'll say, I forgot. You should decide a little. You should understand his viewpoint, and then you should make a decision. I want to understand his viewpoint, and I want to take an adjustment. When we make a decision, then gradually, our intellect becomes such that if he gets angry at us once or twice, then our mind will not accept it. Keep talking. I'll do whatever I want to do. We build a wall in our mind. We build a wall. Then we may hear his words, but we won't listen to them properly. Moreover, we remain upset and disturbed from within. So when we don't follow according to what he says, then he gets more upset with us. So what we should do is, we should understand his point of view. What is he trying to say? What work does he want us to do? In what way does he want us to do the work? We should study that. We should decide that I want to take adjustments. I want to have world interactions in a way that he becomes happy and doesn't get hurt. Do you understand?
Yes, I understood.
Learn how to do pratikraman, okay?
Yes. Jai Sachidanand.
Jai Sachidanand. Trupti Vyas.
Jai Sachidanand Pujushi. Before taking Gnan, I had made certain agreements or promises with files. Their situation was such, or they had problems and they needed help. So I had promised that person that I will help you anytime, come what may. I even stood beside him at that time. This was all before I took Gnan. Now I find it to be a burden. Now I feel that I am unnecessarily having this ego. One person feels good about it and the other person feels abhorrence. When I see the consequences of all these things, then they seem so long-lasting. I feel, how will I come out of it? On top of that, the ego is such that it surely gets its work done. No matter how much I try to explain things to it and keep the awareness of the self, the Prakriti even agrees to it. Yes, we won't do it. However, the ego impulsively jumps in it, instantly does whatever it wants to do. It has become so strong.
What kind of work?
Any promise I have given, that ego of protection does not turn back at all.
You should hold on to the first circle. Husband, wife, children, and parents are your first circle. Then the second circle is family, and the third circle is friends. First, second, and third. Which circle does she jump into?
Into every circle. In the same way.
First, you should take care that it doesn't hurt the first circle. Then help the second circle. If it doesn't hurt the first and second circles, then help the third circle. If you hurt the first circle, hurt the second circle, and then if you try to help the third circle, then you should lessen that and keep this goal. Organize it with understanding. You should first take care of the first circle. If it's time for the children to go to school, at that time, if you go help the other person, then it'll disturb the children's schedule. It should not be like that. First, take care of the first circle. Helping them is all right. You don't need to stop it. However, arrange things according to the circumstances. You should take care of the first circle. Instead of neglecting the family members and going out to help others, help those at home first, and then help the people outside.
The person who is getting the help feels very happy. And many such people come.
They'll also give you a lot of respect.
No, there is no respect as such.
The ego indulges in pride. Such is the nature of the ego. As it jumps to help, in the same way it indulges in pride as well. We may say, no, I don't accept any respect at all. We actually don't realize whether we're indulging in it or not.
Once the work is finished, they kick us out.
What did you say?
Therefore, there is no indulgence in respect.
What?
Once their work is finished, they are the ones that kick us out.
At that time you get affected, don't you?
No, not at all. I already know that this is surely going to happen.
This is surely going to happen. Means the intellect has built walls. This is the way it is. Just let it go. However, one definitely gets respect in doing this. Dada used to say, what we used to do is, if someone says, sir, I have an income tax problem, then I would show him a way out from the back. Then he would express his gratitude towards me. You did such a noble thing. I used to indulge in the pleasure that arises from doership or gurvaras. I'm doing a good for everyone. I was indulging in pride without any apprehension. When his brother told him, you're very egoistic, Dada said, where did you find ego in me? He responded, you have ego in each and every matter. So he checked and found it. Oh, I certainly have all of this in me. I do good for others and take pride in it without any qualms. It is surely a disease in me. Moreover, he used to indulge in garvaras. I'm doing such a noble thing for others. He disclosed it and cleared it. He discloses so much. We get to see a sample that is openly disclosed by the Gnani. It was a mistake of the ego. People think it's such a good thing to help others. We indulge in garvaras and gain respect without any qualms. This certainly happens. It's definitely there. This Prakriti has been hungry for respect for countless lifetimes. Why does she want to get her own way? It's because she gains respect by doing so. It is the Prakriti that is hungry for respect. Dada used to tell me as well, your Prakriti is hungry for respect, but by remaining in satsang, it will be taken care of. Gradually, you will be able to progress further. It wants respect. She feels hurt here at home. And that's why people give tons of respect. Nobody values her at home. That's why she goes outside. Why is that? This is because I want to do good for others and serve them. I want to help the elders. People at home are fed up with her. Oh, please go. It's good. At least we'll be at peace.
The files at home are the ones that need more help.
You said, I'm helping them and I have to help them. I jump to help them. Then where does the question arise? It's a file and you should settle it with equanimity. Actually, we're enjoying it and we don't feel that it's a mistake. We don't think of it as a mistake at all when we're indulging in garvaras. We don't feel that it's a mistake while we're feeding on the respect we're getting. We feel, whatever I'm doing is correct. I'm definitely helping others. One should indeed help, shouldn't they? Hey, one should help, but who are you in this? Vyavasthit is making you do it, and it's a file. This doesn't remain in your understanding. You say, I have to do it. I end up jumping and doing it. I've made promises previously. Now, I find it burdensome. You should know all this and settle it. Do you understand?
I fear that now. When I am turning back and setting gnan, then won't the other person feel hurt?
When you set the five agnas, then there's no need to fear at all. Use the tongs and then you won't get burnt and you'll be able to roast the papadam.
Will they not think that she has changed?
If they think like that, then let them. Here also, the matter of pride arose. What if I look bad in front of them? What if they think I've changed? It's okay if they feel that you've changed. If you're helping people by remaining in gnan, then where is the question of hurting them? What does it mean to leap into action? It so happens, in this, it means we disturb everyone and then leap in. We should consult with five people. I shall do it only if you say so. They'll say, go ahead and do it. It's a good idea. Whereas here, none of them are agreeing with it. We do according to the way we will and want, and therefore people oppose us. Then we say, what can I do? I was just helping others. Hey, at least try to check whether anybody is feeling hurt or not. Is anybody opposing you? They're indeed opposing you. People get fed up and say, just stop it. It's fine if you do less work. You say, I'm just doing it to help others. You're not doing good. Small children say, I'm playing. Hey, you messed up the entire house. You scattered everything around. There are certain children whose parents say, please don't come to the office. Take 5,000 rupees every month for your expense, but don't come to the office. He causes a loss of 15,000 rupees when he comes. That's why they tell him, don't come to the office. Stay at home and do some other work. The ego is such, we think, I'm certainly correct. The business of the ego is indeed like that. He never feels that it's his mistake. He feels, I'm absolutely correct. And what is referred to as correct? It's when five people come to us and say, please come and do this work. Why didn't you come? We've been thinking about you. Please come quickly and help. On the contrary, people say, it'll be better if you don't come. There may be one person who's asking you to come. This is because he's desperate and needs help. Call her, otherwise she'll spoil all the work. They call you due to their helplessness. And you think, my value has increased so much. It's not that your value has increased. People are calling you out of compulsion. We've come here to get our work of liberation done, not to do the welfare of others. If the circumstances arise, then settle the file. Do you understand?
Yes. Jai Sachidanand.
If you feel burdened by the promises, then do pratyakhan for 1 hour in samayik. Recall what promises you have given to whom. It's just your belief. You may have told three people that, I'll help you. And in your head, you believe, oh, my nature is so benevolent. I made promises to the entire world. If people call me, then I have to go. And I find that very burdensome. These are all two-sided tricks of the intellect. You think, I've committed an offense by making promises, and I feel burdened while helping people. However, you indulge in pride from both sides. Therefore, both are wrong types of interferences. Instead, remain natural and spontaneous, and do the worldly interactions that suit everyone. If somebody has an objection in that, you should tell file one, see, don't behave in a way that hurts this person. do pratikraman, and take adjustments in a way that suits everyone. Do you understand? Didn't you understand?
Yes, I understand.
Biju. Look, she's giving us a sample of the ego. Go ahead.
Jai Sachidanand Deepak Bhai. I read the book Anger, and then I made a firm determination that I do not want to get angry at all. But today, when we were coming from Cardiff, after 15 minutes, I realized that I had left my phone at home. Then immediately I got angry at File 2. Because I was busy packing your stuff and giving you your wallet and your phone, I forgot my phone at home.
So you got angry at him?
Yes, after I got angry.
So what did he do in response to that? Has your File 2 come?
Yes, he has come.
So what did he do in response?
He did not say anything.
He didn't say anything?
5 minutes later, I realized that it is File 1's fault. And I even told her, you took the charger and you are the one that forgot to take the phone. Then why did you accuse him? I asked for forgiveness from within, but I did not ask for forgiveness verbally.
Oh, you didn't ask, did you?
No.
So there's that much weakness. You could have asked for it in person. He's your family member, isn't he? The apparent loss is ultimately beneficial.
No, but in person...
He won't punish you by throwing you in prison.
Even then, I am not able to do it in person.
You disclosed that in front of 500 people, but you couldn't tell File 2? However, it is as good as telling him in person. You disclosed it.
Secondly, I used to get very angry. I used to feel angry more at my sister. I have 4 files at home who are disabled. My mother, father, and my brother or sister. Before attaining this Gnan, I used to end up getting angry at them a lot. Why didn't you go to live with her? And why did you come to live with me? I often felt this way. After attaining this Gnan, I came to know that all this is my karmic account.
You realized it, didn't you?
Then I did lots of pratikraman for them, and I saw them as flawless. Now she says, whenever you have to go for satsang, then let me know. I will come. So now she comes home.
Your sister.
To take care of the files so that we can come for this satsang.
Very good. See? It made a difference by doing pratikraman, didn't it?
I used to get very angry at her before.
You washed all that off, didn't you?
Yes.
Very nice.
However, it does not happen with File 2 yet.
You haven't washed it. When you wash it, then it'll be cleared as well.
This is because, say for example, you may have incurred a loss of 25,000 rupees with those people, whereas you've incurred a loss of 500,000 rupees with him.
It'll take more time to clear the debt. Now it'll get cleared. It started, hasn't it?
Yes.
Now we've realized that it's the fault of File 1 and not of File 2. What happens is we blame him. I forgot my phone because of you. We scold and threaten him while the poor man does penance. Oh.
I'm very good at scolding.
Our moksha will remain pending. There is a story about horns. There's the cast iron from which they make small castings. When they do the casting, there are 2 things, the riser and the runner. If they grind it, then the small pieces break down. So what they do is, there's a tumbling barrel. They put those pieces in that. In the tumbling barrel, the angles are welded in between. So the pieces tumble up and then they come clashing down. They tumble up and down. With whom do they clash? They clash amongst each other. The pieces of cast iron collide with the angles, and they clashed amongst each other as well. In this way, all their horns break. Then there are a few hard cast iron pieces. They break the horns of the rest of them. They themselves remain as is. They wear down and become shiny, but they don't reduce.
Do something that it wears down.
It's going to happen to you. You're not protecting it, so your horns are going to break. Let's understand this example. What happens is, the engineer or the foreman keeps those few on the side. They do the second batch. In this way, around 50 pieces are collected in 6 to 8 hours. Those 50 pieces are then put in an 8-hour cycle. Then they collide with each other, and their horns break. Similarly, we've come in this Kali Yuga. We've come with these horns. Now, we're colliding in this tumbling barrel. So, if someone breaks the horn, then we should be happy. It's good that one horn broke. That much less trouble. You should feel grateful towards that person.
Is there any difference between gusso and krodh?
Gusso is filled stock of karma. Krodh is when the living ego gets engrossed in it. Then it's referred to as krodh. If there's a violent intent and a lingering effect, then it's referred to as krodh. Whereas gusso is the filled stock of karma. You recognize that file one got emotional and blamed file two. The jagruti of I am pure soul arose, didn't it? So it's not called krodh. It's referred to as gusso. The firecracker burst and then it subsided. It doesn't have a lingering effect. On the contrary, one repents for it. One does not protect it. On the contrary, one repents for it. You feel that what you did was wrong. Previously, you used to feel, I'm not doing anything wrong. I'm indeed doing the right thing. Now you feel, I made a mistake. So there's no violent intent. There's no lingering effect. So it's not considered krodh. Do you understand?
Yes. Jai Sachidanand.
Mitesh Shah.
Jai Sachidanand Deepak Bhai. It is written on page number 11, recognize the knower. Is that Dada's conversation with one who has taken this Gnan or the one who has not taken Gnan? This is because if the conversation is with the one who has taken Gnan, then Dada has mentioned here that it is such that one who gets angry does not know. The one who is greedy does not know. The one with pride does not know. The knower is different. Whereas these people think in their mind, I know all this. Yet why does it happen? Now who is the one who says, I know? They do not know this. They do not know who it is that knows. That is the only thing they need to discover. If one discovers the knower, then it is possible to get rid of everything. One does not know. To know means that it indeed leaves. It will not remain standing at all.
The conversation is with one who has not attained Gnan.
Correct.
Mainly the ego gets engrossed in the anger, pride, deceit, greed that takes place. That's why one becomes the one with anger, the one with pride, the one with greed, the one with deceit, the one with illusory attachment. He becomes blind. In the illumination of the original self, we know anger is wrong. However, when the anger comes into effect, then we don't realize it. When the effect finishes, then the heart says, this is wrong. I ended up hurting the other person. At the same time, we realize it in the illumination of the self. Therefore, the original knower is the self. Dada is telling the ego, realize the knower. When you realize, who am I, or I am the form as the self, then you'll be free from anger, pride, deceit, greed. Thereafter, the filled stock of karma will gradually shed off. In anger, one becomes engrossed with it. When pride is giving effect, we become filled with pride. That belief in prevalence and pride is referred to as blindness. One becomes blinded by pride, blinded by anger, blinded by greed, blinded by sexuality. When one becomes engrossed in the effect, then blindness arises. But even above this blindness, the self is indeed there as an illuminator. Therefore, one can know. One does not have the awareness at the time of the effect, but later, one surely realizes that I did wrong.
But in the question and answer sessions that happen with our Mahatmas, the talk is mostly, I realize it, but I'm not able to stop it.
Our Mahatmas have come into the seat of the direct light of the self, the discharge ego, and the filled stock of karma, both get together, and this happens. Later, Jagruti arises. We have bound all of that with the sense of doership. All of that is unwinding with the sense of, I am the sufferer. At that time, we feel that the awareness is lost. When the matter is over, then the jagruti arises. However, what kind of jagruti arises? It's of the direct light of the self. For that person, the one who is not taking gnan, the auspicious intellect arises. He feels heartily that, I'm doing wrong. I should not hurt anyone. Whereas for us, the gnan presents itself. This happened by file one, and I am pure soul.
So can we say that we have partial conviction?
No, we have full conviction. We know the knower and we also have the awareness that this is who I am. Conviction means we have the awareness. We also have jagruti of 15%. However, when the force of karma of 50, 80 or 100 comes, then we feel that the jagruti was not completely helpful. When the force of karma decreases, 50, 40, 30, and when it comes to 20, then the jagruti arises. Whatever is happening is wrong. It should not be like that. Then we do pratikraman and wash it off. Thereafter, our jagriti will increase from 15 to 20% and the force of the filled stock of karma will decrease. In this way, the energy will keep increasing and the filled stock of karma will keep decreasing. Do you understand? It's considered as knowing the knower after attaining our gnan.
Jai Satchidananda.